introduce to you guys a new kind of fabric, and we're going to call it Fab Hand Fabric. And first, we're just going to talk about quickly the problem that this addresses for both of us. For me, I can't shred fabric with spandex in it, and so we keep it all for reuse, and that could be yards of fabric or it could be small pieces, but we can't shred it, so I don't have another option for it.
And we actually have the capacity to do it and then make it into a new fabric, then the woven.
So yeah. Logistically, I can sort by color, and then it can get woven, and the missing piece there is a cutting machine to just create the strips from the fabric. So that's part of where this money would go, would be a cutting machine. And together we can make sample books of 3 to 5 new fabrics, fab hand fabrics, that are completely upcycled and recycled. We will both have shops where we can show the fabric. People can order the fabric to whatever width they want. It's great for designers who are looking for a sustainable fabric for their new designs.
Yeah, and then we also have, so we both have an outlet to sell it, okay? We're in development.
Yeah.
Okay, so we can customize it, and the great part about it is, like, it's about, you know, educating, and it's also the craftsmanship. Okay.
And the environmental impact could potentially be really great for us. 45% of the fabric that we get has spandex content and can't be shredded, so this creates a totally upcycled and usable material from what would otherwise be waste. We're thinking that this would only take us a month or two to prep the samples, and that's me sorting, the weaving, the cutting, and the packaging to create 2 sets.
Yes.
So we can both have one.
The 2 sets of books, she'll have a book and I'll have a book, so like if her customers go to her, then they can choose, and then we also have one. Okay.
And we can potentially, from an order, turn that fabric around in as little as like 7 to 10 business days. So for a brand who's looking for a totally upcycled fabric, it's a real solution. The price point is going to be a little bit more on the luxury side. We could do a version that's a little smaller with different fabrics for a more mainstream price point by the yard. Mm-hmm. And then for the rest of the $5,000, the cutting machine costs about $1,000. Yarns and materials.
It's $500. Yeah, that's for the war.
We'll put about $1,000 towards packaging, and then that leaves a little bit for labor and potentially a designer spokesperson to make something from the fabric that then we can showcase so people can see how it can be used and what can be.